Hello everyone, my name is Prabhakar Mishra. I work with Cisco Tech in WAN Access Technologies. In this video, I'll be showing you how to analyze the debugs to understand the issues in the PPP OE. Before we go for troubleshooting, it's always better to check if the client is configured properly. If you wish to check the configuration of the device, please feel free to follow the link. Check the authentication mechanism that is used by your service provider. This slide shows a PPPoE client and a PPPoE server with the different stages of PPPoE. Now let's have a look at the different stages of PPPoE in some detail. PPPoE discovery stage consists of a PaDE packet being sent from the client to the server. Thereafter, the server sends a PaDO packet, that is PPPoE Active Discovery Offer. On receiving the PaDO packet from the server, the client sends a PDR packet, that is PPPoE Active Discovery Request. Once the server receives a PDR packet, it sends a PADS packet, that is PPPoE Active Discovery Session Confirmation to the client, and the session is established. Once the session is established, data is sent as in any other PPP encapsulation. Now we have a look at the different debugs that are helpful in analyzing the session of PPPoE. The different PPPoE debugs that you would run to analyze is debug PPPoE events, debug PPPoE errors, debug PPPoE packet, and debug PPP negotiation to understand the negotiation between the client and the server. There are four main reasons for the failure of PPP negotiation. If the client is sending a PaDE packet but it doesn't receive a PaDO packet from the server, it indicates a failure in the ISP circuit, and therefore we need to contact the ISP for further investigation. Link control protocol is not open. It occurs when there is a mismatch in PPP options between the client and the server. Authentication failure. In case the server fails to authenticate the client, we get an authentication failure. Whether it is an inbound or an outbound CONFNAC, it is an indicative of PPP configuration mismatch. Now, let's jump to the router and see the different packets that are being sent from the client and received by it. This is my client router in the lab, and now I will show you the different packets that are being sent by the client and received by it by running the debugs. So, the very first debug that I've run is debug PPPoE event. Now, I'll run the debug PPPoE packet. After that, we run the debug PPPoE error. And finally, I'll run the debug PPP negotiation to understand the negotiation between the client and the server. Now, I'll clear the PPPoE session that are currently there to understand the flow of packets between the client and the server. Here, we can see that the client is sending a PaDE packet and the server is responding with a PaDO packet. After that, the client requests for a session by sending the PADR packet. and then gets a PADS packet from the server, thereby confirming the session. However, in the PPP negotiation, we can see that the authentication failed message is there, which indicates that the authentication between the client and the server failed. This could be because of the two reasons. Either the authentication mechanism has been improperly configured on the client, or the username and password is incorrectly configured. So now let's check the configuration of this device to check what is the configured username and password. We know that the expected username and password is Cisco, Cisco. Here, we can see that the configured username password is Cisco and XYZ, which is not what is expected. So, I'll go ahead and rectify it. Now I have corrected the password that is on our client side. And now we'll check the packets that have been sent by the client and received by it by running the debugs again. Here, we can see that after changing the password and the phrase has come up. That means that the problem was with the configured username and password. And once we rectified it, the phrase is up and the session is established. We can see the currently established session by running the command so PPPoE sessions. In case you'd like to troubleshoot further, please feel free to visit the following link. Thank you for watching this video. Have a good day.